Welcome back to Let's Read Judge Dredd. Today's episode is The Great Plastine Disaster. Let's dig into that. 9 a.m. Megacity Spaceport at the Interspace Corporation's new cargo terminal 43. Calamity was about to occur.
Doc, look at that pillar. Someone's eating it away. We got the whole terminal's coming down.
It was only the beginning of The Great Plastine Disaster. Yeah, it looks like they're done. Splat. Justice Department rescue teams rushed to the scene. Among them was Judge Dredd.
We've isolated the cause, Dredd. A bacteria that destroys plastine must have come in on one of Interspace's vessels. The pillars supporting the terminal were made of a new dry hard plastine. It's the first building of its type, thank goodness. My bite mic is dissolving in my hand. The bacteria spreads fast. A city without plastine, Doc. You tell the tech boys they better find out how to kill the bacteria, or there's going to be chaos.
Dredd's words proved all too prophetic. Plastine was a material of the 22nd century. Cheap and versatile, it could be as hard as rock or as soft as tissue paper. It had a million and one uses, as the industry's adverts pointed out. They made plastine hats.
Huh?
Plastine wigs.
Oh, dear.
And plastine boots and suits.
Oh, no.
Even plastine underwear.
Help! Help!
Someone somewhere's fetish just came true. Not to mention plastine dentures. They made plastine tires.
Look out! Ah!
Plastine suspension cables. Aye! Even plastine burglar alarms. And plastine bulletproof security screens. As the plastine disaster toll mounted, judges worked tirelessly, but it was a losing battle.
Half the city's been hit now, Dredd. Another day and there won't be a bit of plastine left. The labs have come up with a chemical that kills the bacteria, but it's got to be in the plastine to start with. We've lost this one. All we can do is count the cost.
The cost? You count the cost, Chief Judge. I'll go find someone to pay for it.
Dredd drove across city to the headquarters of Interspace, the giant corporation owned by billionaires K.K. Danvers. There, Dredd was met by Danvers' lawyer.
Mr. Danvers has recently undergone a serious operation, Judge Dredd. I can't allow you to disturb him.
I'll disturb him, all right. Inner spaceships brought that bacteria in, and I'm holding Danvers responsible.
The bacteria may have been found in the Incur terminal, but that does not prove Inner Space brought it in. I warn you, Judge, Mr. Danvers is a very rich man.
Suddenly,
where's Danvers? That bacteria cost our companies a lot of money. We've got writs to serve on Interspace. We're gonna take that creep for every penny he's got. You're out of order.
Push off, rat face.
We've got writs to serve. We've got the right to serve these writs. Don't try to stop us, Judge Dredd.
The thought never even crossed my mind.
What's the meaning of this?
Hey, Danvers is in an isolation tent. It's just a trick to stop us from seven Brits. Danvers knows he's got to replace. They've got a place in his hand. They got to be placed in his hand. You're not squirming out of this one, Danvers. My son died in a blasting crash.
No, please, you don't understand.
Contaminated air rushed into the tent.
It's the Danvers. He's dead.
All the money in the world won't help him now, lawyer. But what killed him?
The operation I mentioned. I should have told you. Mr. Danvers had a heart disease. Last month, doctors replaced his own heart with an artificial one. A plastine heart.
Womp womp. Next issue, The Black Plague. Won't you join us then? I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.